Hello everyone and welcome to today's flight and Twitch stream where we're flying the Canadian Express June 23rd VFRiday where this week we're visiting Block Island. Basically today we will be flying to, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4 different airports, all VFR. We're starting off our current position. There you go. Currently we're at Chatham Municipal and from here we'll be flying VFR to Mantucket, then to Martha's Vineyard, and then on to our final destination, Block Island. Our cruise altitude today will vary between 2,500 feet and 4,500 feet. Aircraft we're flying today is the Canadian Express Jetstream 31. We'll be carrying 15 passengers. And we currently have about 2,300 pounds of fuel on board, which should get us to our destination with the required VFR fuel reserve. If I'm ever running short, well, we'll just simply refuel at Martha's Vineyard if necessary. Our departure time is in approximately 7 minutes. Waiting for other pilots to join up with us. Currently it's myself and two other pilots, but we should have a couple more join us before our scheduled departure time. On the technical cost side of things, the aircraft we're flying today, as I indicated, is the British Aerospace Jetstream 31, which is a payware variant that is by virtual call. Airports, all the airport scenery for today's flights, except for the last one, which I believe is default. In that case, we just have HD airports by Rex. But the other three airports, the first three, are by FTX Orbex, part of the Global North America Freeware Pack. So like I said, we'll be departing in approximately 7-6 minutes, so we're just going to be patient here a little bit, wait for the rest of the company traffic, and then we'll start engines. Alrighty, beacons are on and we're starting our engines. To 2,500 feet for this lake. Okay, we're about 12 miles from the field. We're going to begin our descent and we're going to go straight in on our runway 24. company aircraft ahead of us, Xpress 678, so we'll be following him. touchdown rate on that was minus 173 feet per minute. And we're just sitting here at the gate. We got one pilot that departed a little bit early, and this is a very casual event. We're just going to wait for him to land, and we'll all take off together. Alrighty, so the last aircraft is in. We're going to go ahead and start our engines. So beacon's on. Add some fuel. All right, so we're at 4,500 feet, and I was hoping to be able to punch through and get into VFR conditions, but obviously this isn't it. So we're other pilots are reporting that we need to be around 900 feet or so. So we're gonna try and go down a bit and see what happens. This is definitely not VFR conditions. Vineyard will be doing a left base for runway 24. Going down to 800 feet. Because we still can't see anything. Thank you. Okay, we got the phone. Okay, touchdown rate on that was minus 138 feet per minute. Okay, and the last airport for this evening is Block Island. It's 45 nautical miles. We're going to go up to 4,500 feet. It looks like it's clearing a little bit there, so we're going to give it a shot anyways. We'll see what happens. Starting engines. I'm going to go up to 4,500 here and see what happens. going to start to set down to 800 feet. Okay. So the call is we're going to go straight in runway 28. Hey, Sturman, how's it going? Yeah, I've been a little bit busy with Rare World stuff lately and some other stuff there, but it's good to be back in the cockpit, even though this is supposed to be VFR, and clearly I'm not in VFR conditions, but that's okay. Having fun. Okie dokie, we're at 1,000 feet and we can't see anything, so we're going to go down a bit more. Down 800 feet, see what happens. Alright, going down to 500 feet. Going ahead and putting on our flaps. There we go, we just broke through, so now we just need to find an airport. Yeah, I'd put my money on Pair 3D version 4. A lot more stuff available. Something. Yeah, I just hit some wind shear there. It's gonna be an ocean. Oh well. When I hit that wind shear, I should have gone around like the pilot ahead of me. He hit it also. He was smart, he went around, and I didn't. Because he had the same thing I did, he hit wind shear. Thank you. Hey, just discussing other pilots on our TeamSpeak channel, and so far everyone's hit wind shear coming in, so we'll see how these last two do. Well, that's this concludes this flight as well as this trip stream. Thanks for watching, everyone, and blue skies.